ゲゲゲの鬼太郎妖怪大激戦。こんにちは、人間の皆さん。ゲゲゲの鬼太郎です。妖怪の世界も人間の世界と同じように、妖怪同士仲がいいとは限りません。今回はある妖怪の企みによって起こった大事件の話です。あ、人間には関係ないなんて思わないでください。今回は君にも一緒に戦ってもらいますよ。 風呂の準備ができましたよ。
ああ、頑張るぞ。
父さん、お風呂。
頑張るぞ。
the other attack. This luck sucks. Are you killed yet? Hey Stroll. Is this a sequel? It's just a different game. The Game Boy Advance one was made by Konami. This one's by Bandai. This is not a metroidvania. Though this have a few branching paths in the levels, but it's like just you beat the boss, you can continue. There's optional bosses in levels, but you don't need to do them. A lot of cutscenes though. Probably a bit longer. This game has 10 levels. And they get longer and longer. I think one of the later ones is a bit quicker though, but yeah, they're... The last level is the longest, because you have to fight the final boss two phases. Those two items that I found like quickly during the route, like they increase my health. So I can take 14 hits before dying, as opposed to my default health is only 5. In every game there's a checkpoint, or like a midway point where you can fully heal, so I can do that if I'm running low on health, but it does cost a bit of time to do. Second half of the game, like if I get knocked down the pit, it's a lot of backtracking, so I don't want that to happen. Every level has this area where you talk to the girl and she'll fully heal you. I honestly can't even, I can't read the numbers, but once you collect a certain amount of these green orbs, you become like invincible. Like you have lightning all around you and you can damage everything around you. So you're, like, you're basically immune to damage and like spikes, but it's not really that useful. Because you don't decide when to activate it, it activates automatically once you collect the max amount. Ah, and I fell. There we go. Now... No, I fall, I have to go back. So after stage 5, the game goes into credits, but then it just continues after, like, the story just continues. And you basically have to redo 4 of the stages again. And they have, like, different stronger enemies and, like, a different boss, of course, and then there's the last level, which is the longest. Hey there, White Hat. You can find these items throughout the levels, but like, I only get one that I can combine with the first one that you get by default, and that just increases your max health. Because your default health is only 5. And with those two items, your health is 14. And like everything does 1 damage. And later enemies take a lot of hits to kill, so I'll try and like skip some of them. The race car, but here you have to walk on the tracks. And there's like these pumpkins, and if you float in them, it sends you back to the beginning of the level. If you take the bottom out, it's fine. I don't know how to open that. This part's annoying because you have to do it twice. Like this, you have to redo this level. If you go in that pumpkin by accident, it sends you to the start of the level. Okay, sometimes there's like a cutscene if you land on that, but I don't know what triggers it. But it like sends you to the end of the screen. So I guess we have to do the whole thing normally. Please don't fall. Yeah, this on the second time you play this level, it's it seems like it always triggers the cutscene, but I don't know how it does it on this the first visit here. Trying to finish one more. I honestly have no idea how long it's gonna take. It's over, easily over an hour. Probably I just take the damage boost to walk on the spike so I can make this landing pretty easy. So if you fall down here, you have to go all the way back to the start of screen and do all that whole thing again, and it's a lot of time wasted. If it didn't. Oh, the rats. Oh my god. quite a bit of damage there. I don't want to take any more hits. Take that heal. I think this guy was the second last boss in the last game. But this time he doesn't just float around, he like... Now I have to wait for this to play through. About 2 minutes? Almost 2 minutes. So we have to do all the stages again except the first level. Just do them all over again. The boss doors are in different places this time. I'm only worried about this first level because if I fall, it's a lot of walking back. Thank you.
こんにちは、人間の皆さん。ゲゲゲの鬼太郎です。どうやら妖怪の世界は平和を取り戻したようですね。とりあえず、人間の君にお礼を言わなければいけませんね。でも、妖怪の世界は人間に見える世界だけじゃないんですよ。そう、君の知らない世界で、よからぬことを企む奴らもいるんですよ。お風呂。
Things you can only damage them with your shoes. I got knocked back, but I didn't fall down. Alright, that was very lucky. Because this up here is the only way to get this door, the boss door. Yeah, we have pretty good health. So only this boss and the final boss can invert your controls. Makes it a bit difficult. Heal after. bit close there. This boss around it can just turn into like this poison gas and I won't be able to damage it at all. Yeah, it's basically the same boss as the last game, but this time it's much smaller. Just more annoying to fight. Lucky there without it turning into the poison gas lock. Wow, just once. This was pretty lucky fight. Hey Cactus, happy Easter to you. Just randomly finding them. I mean, I'm pretty sure this series is popular in Japan, so for them it's probably not random. Probably no one outside of Japan knows it exists. Yeah. pretty much like it's much different than the Game Boy Advance game. Not really a metroidvania, it's more linear. This is probably one of the shortest stages in the second half. Fire. This is not good. Get through this screen. Oh my god. Okay, so like this cutscene didn't happen in the first time, but now here it just takes you straight to the end of the screen. Now we can heal. Thank you. where the boss was last time. This time we have to go here. The problem with this boss is that sometimes the fight can take forever. Because if he just walks through those open electric wires, it just heals him. Wanted to like jump over that, but. Last level. Thank you. This screen is annoying. Can't do the fall here on these platforms. The power-up activates on its own. Here, I have to kill these. I need as much health as I can have for the boss. Timing on this is hard, so I just damage boost like that. Alright, final boss now, and there's two phases. The last one's really long, it just takes so long to do. And I just hope we don't die. We have good health. Again, you can invert your controls too. He already did right away. Oh, that. Alright, we have 10 health for the final phase. Let's just get lucky. Should I just throw my shoes at him to do as many hits as I can? And this ball is, just goes across the field too, and that damages you. You can break the control suit too. And occasionally he'll just give himself a shield so you can't damage him like that. I think I'm supposed to like just damage it, or it like goes over time on its own. Magic sword, so weapons, so that's pretty good for now. Oh, there goes the shield, it's been a while. He's just constantly inverting your controls. There was another one up there that you didn't see. That's cheap. Yeah, I don't bother shooting him because you have to like shoot him in midair and like aim at the center of his eye. So it's like the sandals like can do like three hits when it comes back down. All right, well there you go. Deathless run. I only fell once on level three. Only level 4, like the first loop.
We got this, man! We got this by the ass!
World record, only one with a run. All the long plays are like over 3 hours long. You see like when I combine the two items to increase my health. There's like 20 items or so. They're like all over the maps. Like, you think you have to like fight optional bosses to get some of them. But I only get one right before the second boss. That just gives me an extra 3 health, which definitely helped at that one level. I was down to 2 health. Yeah, I took a lot of damage on that one, but thanks for GG's Cactus and White Hat. I think I'm good learning hour-long games for now. Let's get down to something shorter next time. Under 30 minutes. Can do the boss rush. So fight all the boss at once on one health bar without healing in between. Yeah, like these bosses take so long to kill, like. Again, I don't know if there's like a power up that may increase your damage input, but I haven't found anything that's like nearby on the way throughout the route. You probably have to go out of your way to get them. Music is solid, yeah, I agree. So yeah, I said like the Game Boy Advance one was made by Konami, it was a metroidvania, and this one's